Hello friends, in this session we are going to take up question 9 to 11 of class 5 Aryabhatta paper 2018 part 2. So let's look at this question. A tank with a base measuring 40 cm by 20 cm is 3/4 filled with water. When 16 liter of water is added, the tank becomes 7/8 full. The height of the water in the tank when it is 5/8 full is, so it's a, the tank is in the form of a cuboid. So let the height of the tank be h. So when it is 3/4 full, the volume is 40 into 20 into 3/4 h, and after that we add 16 liters of water, which is nothing but 16,000 ml or 16,000 centimeter cube. Why are we converting this? Because all the dimensions are given in centimeters. So if we add 16,000 centimeter cube of water to it, it becomes 7/8 full. So it becomes 40 into 20 into 7/8 h. So this gives us 16,000 is equal to 40 into 20 into 1/8 h. So this gives us h is equal to 160 centimeter. Now what will be the height of water when it is 5/8 full? Will be obviously 5/8 into h. So this is nothing but 100 centimeters. So this is the answer to this question. Moving to the next question, look at the given figure and answer the following questions. Now LMNO is a rhombus and NT is equal to LO. So this NT is equal to LO, and since LMNO is a rhombus, so LM is equal to MN is equal to NO is equal to LO. So let's call this angle 1 and this angle 2. So clearly in triangle NOT, angle 1 is equal to angle 2 because NO is equal to NT. So now if these two angles are equal and the sum of the angles of a triangle is 180 degrees, so angle 1 will be equal to 180 minus 32 divided by 2. That gives us 74 degrees. So angle 1 is nothing but what we have to find out, angle LON. So this is 74 degrees. Now moving to the second part of the question, we have to find the measure of angle OLN, this angle. Right? So now we take the triangle LON. In this we know that OL is equal to ON. So this implies that angle OLN is equal to angle ONL. And since the sum of the angles is 180 degrees, so angle OLN is equal to 180 minus angle 1 by 2. Now angle 1 we know is 74. So this becomes 53 degree. So this is the answer to the second part of the question. Now we have to find the sum of the angles of polygon LRTONM. Now since this is a six-sided figure, we know that sum of the angles of a polygon is given by n minus 2, where n is 6 in this case, into 180 degree. So this is 4 into 180, which is 720 degree. So this is the answer to this part of the question. Moving to the last question of this session, look at the given figure and answer the following questions. So first we have to give the number of radii. Now what are the different radius? Radius we know is the point, is the line which connects the center of the circle to any point on the circumference. So here we have OP as the radius, OQ as the radius, OR and OC. So we have four radii here. Now we need to find out the measure of angle TSR. So first of all, we know that this angle is 50 degree because one angle is given to be 130, so 180 minus 130 is 50 degree. Now we know that OQ is equal to OR obviously both being the radius, and this angle is also 50, this is also 50. So since these two sides are equal, angle OQR is equal to angle ORQ will be both 50 degree, right? So this becomes angle QOR becomes 180 minus 50 minus 50. So this is 80 degree, right? So this angle becomes 80 degree. Now we know that angle OQOR is equal to angle TSR, because OQ and ST are parallel lines. These angles are both given to be 90 degree. So these are two parallel lines, which would mean that the alternate interior angles will be equal. So this becomes 80 degree. So angle TSR is 80 degree. Now we need to find out the angle OPC, which is this angle, right? So angle, now QOR is 80 degree and QOT is given to be 90 degree. This implies that angle ROT is 10 degree, and this is equal to the sum of the opposite angles of the triangle, because this is the external angle. Now this would mean, and since OP is equal to OC, these two angles would be equal. Let's call them 1 and 2. So these two angles would be equal, and they will be equal to 10 by 2, which is 5 degree. So this angle will come out to be 5 degree. Name a pair of parallel lines. As we've already said, OQ is parallel to TS. Shade a major segment. So let's say P, we can take PC as the chord, and then we can, let's take a different color. This is one of the major segments. Then there are others also. Now name a pair of vertical angles. Now the vertical angles are basically the vertically opposite angles, which are clearly angle, this angle here and this angle here. So which is ORQ and angle TRS. So these are the, this is for F. These are the vertical angles. Number of chords that are there. Number of chords we can see are PC, QR, and PR. So we have three chords. And name a pair of linear angles. So linear angles are angle OPQ and angle ORT. Sorry, this will be angle ORQ and angle ORT. So ORQ is this angle, ORQ is this angle, and ORT is this angle. So they form a pair of linear angles, ORQ and ORT. Friends, you can visit us at our Cool Smart Learning website and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get updates on the new sessions.